Welcome to the channel. I'm Cheryl, and this is True Crime and Other Stuff. Today, we have more information on Brian Goldberger, the Idaho 4 suspect. If you like true crime with all facts and no BS, then you should subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up. Thanks. Have a nice day.
Eight-year-old man charged with the brutal murders of four University of Idaho students as they were sleeping is due in court on Tuesday. Brian Goldberger now faces four counts of first-degree murder. He was arrested on Friday in Pennsylvania, thousands of miles away from the crime scene. His attorney says he'll waive his extradition hearing because he's, quote, eager to be exonerated. A childhood friend reveals new details tonight about the 28-year-old graduate student. Here's ABC's Kana Whitworth.
Tonight, Brian Goldberger's childhood friend Thomas speaking to ABC News, describing the Idaho murder suspect as mean in high school, saying Brian was eager to be seen as dominant.
He would just like put me in, he would like grapple me and like put me in headlocks and arm bars and stuff like that.
Goldberger's family releasing a statement which reads in part, "First and foremost, we care deeply for the four families who have lost their precious children. There are no words that can adequately express the sadness we feel. We have fully cooperated with law enforcement agencies in an attempt to seek the truth and promote his presumption of innocence." The small community in Moscow terrified for weeks after roommates Kaylee Gonzalez, Madison Mogan, Zanna Kernodle, and her boyfriend Ethan Chapin were found stabbed to death in their off-campus home in mid-November. Goldberger's lawyer saying Brian's father flew from his home in the Poconos to Washington State for a pre-planned cross-country road trip back home to Pennsylvania for Christmas in that white Hyundai Elantra.
Driving cross-country took them approximately 2.5 days. Mr. Goldberger indicated that Brian was acting normal and not out of character on the drive back from Washington.
The car seized from the Goldberger's home after Brian was arrested early Friday morning. The Monroe County Chief Public Defender saying Goldberger is eager to return to Idaho and be exonerated. Police in Moscow say they're confident they arrested the only person responsible for the murders. Still, they're searching for a murder weapon they describe as a fixed-blade knife. The police chief saying the community has a name and a face, and now they're hoping more people will come forward with information.
We have a lot of work to do still. Mm-hmm. We still have a lot of pieces we have to put together. That's why we're still asking people, if you have known this individual, contact us.
And Lindsay, Chief Fry telling me that within an hour of releasing Goldberger's name, they had more than 400 tips pour in. Also, Goldberger's lawyer confirming to us that he remained there in Pullman working towards his PhD until mid-December. Now, of course, he's set to appear before a judge on Tuesday and is hoping to be quickly sent to Idaho to face charges. Lindsay.
Investigators are combing through every aspect of suspect Brian Goldberger's life as they try to piece together a possible motive in the murders of four University of Idaho college students.
We're trying to build this picture now of him, who he is, his history, how we got to this event.
Law enforcement sources say FBI agents tracked the 28-year-old's movements days leading up to his arrest at his parents' home in eastern Pennsylvania. It's located more than 2,500 miles from the house in Moscow, Idaho, where Goldberger is accused of stabbing Kaylee Gonzalez, Madison Mogan, Zanna Kernodle, and Ethan Chapin while they were sleeping on November 13th. Gonzalez's father says their arrest brings some relief.
This is the first bit of joy that we've had in close to 7 weeks. We hope they picked the right guy, and that gives us hope, and we haven't had hope for a long time.
Goldberger is a PhD criminology student at Washington State University and lived in Pullman, Washington, about a 15-minute drive from the victims. Police haven't found a murder weapon or said if Goldberger knew the students. Law enforcement sources say forensic analysis allegedly linked him to the murders. The public defender representing Goldberger in the extradition says about a month after the murders, his client went on a road trip home to Pennsylvania with his father that was planned at the beginning of the semester. They were in a white Hyundai Elantra. It's the same make and model of the vehicle spotted near the scene of the murders.
The police department believes that the person we have in custody, which would be Goldberger, is the one who is responsible for these crimes.
Days after his arrest, 28-year-old Brian Goldberger is awaiting extradition to Idaho, where he faces four counts of first-degree murder in the slayings of four University of Idaho students.
He has been named as our suspect, and we believe he is the one that is responsible.
Authorities tracked Koberger for 4 days before arresting him at his parents' Eastern Pennsylvania home early Friday morning, roughly 2,000 miles from Washington State University, where he was enrolled as a criminal justice PhD student, and from the University of Idaho, where Kaylee Gonsalves, Madison Mogan, Zanna Kernodle, and Ethan Chapin were brutally killed. Koberger is set to appear in a Pennsylvania courtroom on Tuesday. He's expected to waive extradition and be taken back to Idaho. Once in front of a judge, the probable cause affidavit will be unsealed, revealing how investigators zeroed in on him. But it's believed genetic genealogy evidence pointed police to...
Moscow police contend with one of their most difficult cases in years. The chief, emotional and grateful for his officers.
They work hard. They did it right. And the investigators and all of the team we brought in did it right. And I'm proud of them.